thanks for joining us right here on Midday Kentucky. This kettle of fish is back, let me tell you. How are you, my darling?
I'm doing good.
Good. You've got a little bit darker with your hair.
Yes.
You told me not to mention it, but when you tell me not to do something, it's going to happen.
Right out of the gate, huh?
How was your trip?
Oh, it was wonderful. We stayed at the Baywatch Resort.
How
was
good.
Oh, my. So mean to me. But yeah, we stayed at the Baywatch Resort. We had so much fun.
Did you see Pamela?
Pamela, yeah, she was like literally slow-mo running across the beach. It was crazy. My kids were like, But yeah, it was a lot of fun. We went jet skiing to see dolphins, all kinds of stuff.
We saw some pictures. Did you tag Doug? But Doug didn't come out
for it.
You just tagged him
as
if he was there.
Right.
I want him to confuse everyone.
I want him to see the pictures and see the fun that we're having while he's, you know, out there with hearing
guns and doing all that. I got you. Well, welcome back. And we've all decided no more time off for you.
I know.
Till after Christmas.
That's what I find out when I get back.
Yeah, it's enough. You've had enough.
Well, you know, somebody's got to carry the weight around here.
Exactly.
So I guess I got to step.
Hey, something, I've been watching this new show called 90 Days Fiancé.
Okay.
And I wanted to get your take on this. I started watching it last night because I was a little bored.
Uh-huh.
All right? And I started thinking to myself, would I do something like this? Let me tell you a little bit about 90 Days Fiancé. What they are these men and women who, it's obviously a TV show, of course, on TLC, but which I call bad TV on TLC. But what they do is they go online and they find a potential date that lives overseas. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
They meet them, they chat and, you know, all that sort. They don't meet them first straight away. So it might go on for like 3, 4, 5 months. Then TLC jump on the plane and then they take them to where their desired love will be.
Okay.
Then they get engaged or married or whatever. Then the part two of the show is where they follow the marriage.
Okay.
Does that make sense? You're on there with me so far? Here's the thing. I watched it last night and it broke my heart a little bit. Because there was a part of me that thinks, well, I've also done something like that. And I thought to myself, would you do it, Katie? Would you, if you met someone online from Croatia, okay?
Okay.
And for 5 months, you've been FaceTiming, you have been communicating, but you've only met online.
Mm-hmm.
You haven't met them in person. Would you jump on a plane after 4 or 5 months and go to meet them, or would you prefer them to come to you?
I wouldn't wait 4 or 5 months. There's no way I would carry on
for that
wasting
long.
My time like that.
Okay.
So I don't know if I would go or not, but I think that can be applied to even like dating here. I'll know people, you're
from
in the same
state.
City. They'll meet online, and they'll spend weeks and weeks and weeks talking just to meet up and find out you don't like each
other. I'll tell you why you're waiting weeks and weeks, because you need to lose probably 10 pounds.
To look like your profile
you need
picture.
To get to, yes. You need to get everything sorted before you see them. Trust me.
So they're catfishing you, is what I'm saying.
You're what?
You're getting catfished.
I don't know what that is.
That's when people pretend like they're something or someone
that
they're not
online. Oh.
And that's why people wait so long. That's why you got to meet right away.
Yeah. You're kind of doing research too.
Yeah.
I think
all right. Well, let me show you these people because one of them's actually from Kentucky. All right. So let's start off with Darcy Sibla and Jesse Meester, I should say. Now, this is the chick. She's 42 years old. This guy lives in Amsterdam. He's 24, personal trainer. Part two this Sunday. I don't think he's meeting her at the airport because there was a screenshot of her crying last night at the airport. So I'm thinking he dumped her. Big age difference. She's got 3 kids. That's the way that's going down. Sean and Abby. Okay. Now, this guy is from Ohio, I think he is. Now, and she is also from Haiti. She's 20 years of age, but she has another older boyfriend who's 60-something on the show as well.
Wait a second.
I know. But it's good.
Wait, there's more to this show than like just
good.
A normal meeting
okay,
someone.
Okay, Paul and Karen. Okay, now this is the guy from Louisville. Well, I have never seen anything so funny in all my life. She's in the Brazilian rainforest. She doesn't speak English.
Okay.
It takes 3 days by boat to get to her once you fly to Brazil. But he packed like 8 big tubs of protection gear. And when I say protection gear, he got into a full body mosquito net because the mosquitoes can kill you there. Okay? He's got all sorts of things to protect himself from dying.
Just to get a woman?
Just to get to her. But here's the thing, on the preview last night, He got robbed with a, I shouldn't laugh, but he got robbed by a guy with a machete in the Brazilian rainforest. And he says, I don't think I'm going to come back alive. Okay? Larry and Jenny, okay? Here's another one. She's a Filipino girl, lovely girl, and, you know, he seems like a nice bloke. I don't know where it's going to go with them, but apparently she's up to no good as well. All right?
So there's more to this story.
No, no, no. This is better than The Bachelor.
But that's what I'm saying. This isn't, as we were discussing in the beginning, just kind of meeting someone and you wait to meet. There's already these circumstances of massive age differences.
Exactly.
Language barriers. Like,
Well, they've been online dating for 3 or 4 months. Okay. Then they go to the country to meet them. Here's the thing. So I had a very good friend of mine. I was living in Australia. One of my closest friends living in New York. She said, you know, Troy, I really think you'd like one of my buddies. All right? I said, all right. So we started chatting on the phone, FaceTiming. Probably 3 or 4 months went by, and I thought, you know what? I'm going to fly him over to Australia. Well, let's meet up. He was Australian. Let's meet up for 2 weeks. Let's see how things go, blah, blah, blah. At that time, I wasn't sure whether I was going to move to New York. It lasted 3 days. I couldn't stand the sight of him.
Like you said, right off the plane.
But then don't you feel like now you just wasted like 3 months chatting
with him? Oh, no, I was happy to let him have a holiday. I put him up in a hotel. I went, you can't stay with me. It just didn't work. And here's the thing. So you can be in love with someone over the phone and, you know, get on so well. Mm-hmm. But there also has to be physical attraction.
Yes.
And I think these guys and these girls in this show, there is physical attraction.
Right.
But it's just great TV.
Well, and Katie, I mean, that's exactly, she's like, why would you wait so long before you finally meet him? You need to meet him pretty quickly,
How long would you wait before you meet someone from who you met online? What's your go-to number?
Like, locally? I would tell anyone a day. They meet for coffee the next day. Like, it doesn't have to be like a big event. If you meet someone, and then I also think I'll hear from a lot of friends online dating that you chat for so long that when you meet up, there's not a lot to talk about because you've already covered sort of some of those
awkwards. But that's sort of the good thing.
But I think you could do that in person. Mm-hmm. Like you could chat, oh, I like you. Hey, let's meet at Starbucks. It could be 10 minutes or it could be an hour. And you just know and you don't waste time.
I don't think there's anything wrong with doing some online dating and getting to know someone and having a conversation beforehand.
Right.
I think
5 months is
like
a long
week
time.
A couple weeks I think is appropriate.
Well, that's 5 pounds.
Yeah, that would be good.
A few weeks, you could drop 5 pounds.
Especially with a juice cleanse.
Yeah, 5 pounds.
Ten days.
Good chemical peel, you're sort of sorted.
Hey,
something, look, you know we talk about crazy stuff here on this show.
No.
And we're talking about a tut-tut towel. And I saw this, I wanted to say, I saw this online and I wanted to talk about it, but I thought you girls would get cross with me. So I'm glad one of you submitted the story. What is a tut-tut towel?
This is so funny. It's all over the internet now. Let's just show the pictures.
Okay.
Let's just dive right into it. So this is basically, it's a towel for the tatas. They say it's for poop sweat, they call it. But I'm like, you know,
how often
are you maybe out of the shower? I'm not ready to be dressed, but I'd like this bra towel. That would be fabulous.
Yeah.
I just think it's one of those things that when you see, you start laughing, and then there's a little part of you that's like,
wow, I really like that
idea. I mean, I would get ready. I wouldn't go out. But if I'm like walking around, I just got out of the shower, throw on my bra towel, do my hair and makeup.
I don't know any woman who wants to get out of the shower
and put a bra on.
You know? No girl wants to put
a bra on right after getting out of the shower.
This is great.
I understand where you're coming from. Because even immediately when I have a shower, I've got the underwear on. Do you know what I mean? I don't walk around. It's not my thing. No. So I can understand why you would probably feel like that as a woman.
Yeah.
I mean, it's uncomfortable.
It's what?
It's uncomfortable.
Well, it depends what size you are, I would assume.
We
want the towel. How much are they?
Oh, they're $45.
Okay, yeah. $45.
They go all the way up to the H cup.
That's big, is it?
Yeah.
Okay. How small do they go?
Well, you could always just use a towel.
Yeah, I was going to say, you could just use a face wash.
Just use a wrap.
You use a wash rag.
You could just wash it.
There's a towel for everyone.
All right. Now we've done our two little risque. What have you got that's quite boring?
Oh, gosh. Mine is not boring. This is very, very important.
Interesting.
It is.
is this a study?
Okay, first of all, how much sleep do you guys get? a night?
Well, I'm now 7 hours. I used to be six.
Okay.
Eight.
8 hours?
With a ta-ta towel.
I probably get...
I wish. I would do nine. It'd be so comfortable.
Well, Katie, you are in the very small, minute group that gets enough sleep, actually, because in the study, they looked at, a research firm looked at sleep deprivation, and they said that if you're getting regularly getting less than 6 hours of sleep a night, that it is just as damaging to your body and to your brain as alcohol abuse. Mm. And they said that 40% of people do not get enough sleep, period. And they're getting less than 6 hours. And what I found interesting was with this was because Doug actually, you know, he works the morning show also. You are very good, Katie, about going to bed and making sure you're getting enough sleep. He does not. He stays up late at 10 o'clock, 11 o'clock, gets up at 4 o'clock in the morning. So he is not getting enough sleep. And we
actually
thought...
He gets up at 4? He's supposed to be at work at 4.
No. He gets here around 4:30, well. Something like that. He gets here. He gets here, Troy.
Just obviously.
Yeah.
As but long as he shows up, I don't care.
Yeah.
When he
got, but the thing
come
was,
back.
The thing that, the thing is that we actually had someone, a professional, concerned about his sleep deprivation, and before he left for the Navy, they had him go up to Dayton to take a test, a cognitive type test, before being sent over, and he failed it, the first one, because he had no sleep. He was, you know, he was running on fumes getting there, and it was just a simple, basic test. And so we've seen that firsthand work with him. Of course, he had to go back in, he got a good night's sleep, went in and nailed it. But they said if you're doing that once in a while, it's not going to be damaging. It's when you're lacking in sleep regularly is where it's very damaging, and it can cause obesity, depression, heart attacks, strokes. It's all linked to it. Completely.
Only for 6 hours.
If you're getting less than 6 hours on a regular basis.
I will say, I've been now making sure I get seven,
uh-huh.
and I do feel a lot better.
Yeah.
Does that make sense?
Mm-hmm.
Because I am a night owl, and you know, you were saying that you, did you end up putting up your blackout curtains?
Oh, no, I do a memory foam mask
oh,
instead.
That's right. Yeah. Lord.
Unless someone well, wants to come put my curtains up for me, I tried, I couldn't do it, so
okay.
I gave up.
All right,
well, if folks are struggling with their sleep, the mask is something actually that
what
they
recommend.
What else
have you got there on page they seven of this study?
I know you love studies, don't you?
I do,
But they said avoid regular afternoon naps. They said don't do that, wear an eye mask, earplugs, don't sleep with pets. There you go. And turn your alarm clock against the wall so you're not constantly looking at
oh, that's
the clock
clever.
All the time.
Yep,
so,
good.
Yeah. So the
fascinating. Did you put it online?
Yes.
Good.
It's on
tell
there.
Us what you think. Head over to Midday Kentucky's Facebook page. Everyone, up next, do you wonder if your child needs to go to the dentist before the new school year? Dr. Gina Johnson-Higgins is in the studio. Stick with us, everyone. You're watching Midday Kentucky.